Chapter 1, Intro. Hello, smart home enthusiasts, and welcome back. I'm Martin, and around here we try to bring some order to the chaos of smart homes, at least enough so they don't completely drive us mad. Today, we're taking a closer look at the Innr ZigBee Smart Plug SP242, a compact device with built-in energy monitoring. Chapter 2, Disclaimer. Let's get the formalities out of the way first. This is an honest, unsponsored review. Innr didn't send me the product or pay me in any way. I purchased the SP242 myself in September 2025 on Amazon for £19.99, with free next-day delivery. Chapter 3, What's in the box? Let's take a look at what is included. Inside the box, you'll find a leaflet about Innr Smart Lighting, complete with a 20% discount code. A quick start guide. A smart plug that feels sturdy and well-built. Below are the specifications provided by the manufacturer. Chapter 4, Home Assistant Setup. Time to roll up our sleeves and see this plug in action. We are going to connect it to the ZigBee network, and I'll walk you through a clear step-by-step guide for setting it up with ZigBee 2 MQTT. Step 1. Pair the plug. Open the ZigBee 2 MQTT dashboard and enable Permit Join to let new devices join your network. Connect the SP242 to a power outlet. The power button on the side should begin blinking, showing that it's in pairing mode. If it doesn't enter pairing mode automatically, press and hold the power button for about 5 seconds until the LED starts flashing. After a few moments, the plug should appear in your ZigBee 2 MQTT device list. Once it does, turn off join mode to keep your network secure from unwanted devices. Step 2. Name your device. When you first add the plug, it may show up as offline. Don't panic. It is not broken, just pretending to be shy. Giving it a proper name usually snaps it out of it and updates the status to online. Pick a name that makes sense. And remember to tick Update Home Assistant Entity ID, so the name sticks everywhere. Need naming ideas? I've got you covered. Check out my video, The Perfect Naming Conventions Simplify Your Smart Home. Step 3, Customize Settings. Head to the ZigBee 2 MQTT device list. Find your shiny new plug and click on it. In the About tab, add a short description. Under the Exposes tab, set the Power On behavior. Finally, in Settings Specific, turn State Action to True This little tweak makes sure Home Assistant always knows whether the plug is on or off. It may sound minor, but it's a crucial detail for keeping both your automations and dashboards reliable. Step 4. Location and labels. Jump over to Home Assistant settings and select Devices and Services. Switch to the Devices tab, find your plug, and open it. Tap the pencil icon in the top right corner to edit the device, assign it to the correct room, and sprinkle in a few labels so you'll actually remember what it's for. Update your changes and watch chaos magically turn into order. Chapter 5. Over-the-air updates. The SP242 supports OTA updates, so let's make sure it is running the latest firmware. Head back to the ZigBee2 MQTT integration page and open the OTA tab. Find your smart plug in the list and click Check for Updates on the right-hand side of your device entry. I updated my plug, but I only started recording once the upgrade was already in progress. Sorry about that. Still, I can confirm that OTA updates work perfectly on the SP242. Chapter 6. Power Monitoring Validation. To make checking power monitoring easier, I added the smart plug to my dashboard. While testing it, I accidentally discovered the first issue, and it's a serious one. There seems to be a problem with refreshing data from the smart plug. To get measurements, I have to manually force the device to refresh, which, in my opinion, makes the monitoring feature practically useless. Now, let's see how accurate the SP242 is after refreshing its data. I'll compare the readings from Home Assistant with measurements from my multimeter. Voltage. The smart plug reads 247 volts. While the actual voltage is 243 volts. Not bad. Current. The smart plug reports 65 amps, which immediately tells me something is wrong. 65 amps is far too high, as the actual current is only 0.07 amps. Power. The smart plug shows 13 watts, but the correct value should be voltage times current. 243 times 0.07 is equal to 17.3 watts. So, the SP242 is far from accurate. Of course, it's not meant to replace a multimeter, but the current readings it provides are completely off the charts. Chapter 7. Final thoughts. The Innr SP242 is compact, feels well-built, and comes at a reasonable price. Unfortunately, the refresh issue and wildly inaccurate current measurements make its monitoring feature pointless. Reliability is another concern. I've used several Innr plugs in my Home Assistant setup, most of them the older SP222 model without power monitoring, and those have been rock solid. The SP242, however, tells a different story. I own two. One failed after a year. It powers devices but can't be switched off anymore. And the other is brand new. It works for now, but as you've seen, its performance is questionable, and I'm not confident it'll last long. And judging by Amazon reviews, I'm clearly not the only one facing these problems. My verdict? I cannot recommend it. In fact, I'm returning my new unit. I'm still hunting for reliable ZigBee or Matter over Thread smart plugs with power monitoring. If you know a good one, please drop it in the comments below. I read every suggestion, and if something looks promising, I'll buy it, test it, review it, and if it survives, actually keep it in my setup. Chapter 8. Thank you. Big thanks for tuning in. Whether you're just dipping your toes into Home Assistant or already knee-deep in automation wizardry, I truly value your time and attention. If this review helped you out, don't forget to hit that thumbs up button, drop a comment, or share it with a fellow smart home enthusiast. It really makes a difference for the channel. If you'd like to go the extra mile in supporting my work, you'll find links in the description for Buy Me a Coffee and PayPal. Every little bit helps me keep creating more guides, reviews, and tutorials. Thanks again for watching. See you in the next video, and happy smart plugging.